I need to know how to fix a refrigerator water inlet valve.
Turn off the water to the fridge using the shut-off valve in the water line to the fridge.
That only stops the water flow. It doesn't fix the valve.
You want to turn off the water before you replace it anyway, or else you'll have a massive mess.
I've heard that if you want to test the water inlet valve, you have to turn it off, too.
Then put a bucket under the valve to catch any water that leaks out of the valve or its fill tube, before you loosen the tubing.
That's done using a wrench.
You use a wrench to loosen the flare nuts on the fittings. Those are located on the inlet side of the valve. You can use a screwdriver or nut driver to remove the screw that holds the bracket onto the fridge, if you have to take the whole water valve off the fridge.
You have to if you're going to replace it.
I've heard of people cleaning it too. If the reason it isn't yielding enough water flow is due to hard water mineral buildup.
I don't think I could clean it well enough.
And cleaning it won't make a difference if the reason it won't work is that the solenoid that sends power to open and close the gates, the water inlets, isn't working.
Come to think of it, a loose wire to the solenoid could kill the water flow, too.
If we were talking about a washing machine, you would want to check the filter screens. A clogged filter screen in the water supply hose will block water flow.
I've had similar problems with the water dispenser when the water filter in the fridge needs to be replaced. However, there isn't a filter like that that I know of earlier in the water flow.
If your house has low water pressure to the fridge, it may not get enough water to deliver any cold water or ice.
The water line goes through the freezer to make it cold.
And if that water line is frozen solid, you won't get water to the dispenser.
I've already checked that, and I know that a water leak in the freezer isn't the root cause, either.
Let's say we think it is the solenoid in the water inlet valve. You can test them for continuity with a voltmeter.
I have a multimeter.
That works. Just set it to ohm setting 1 or times 1. If the reading shows a number, it is good, while 0 or infinite readings mean it needs to be replaced.
Which one means it is shorted out and which means it is burned out or bad?
Whether you get 10 or the sideways 8 for infinity, it doesn't matter, you need to replace the solenoids. A value of 200 to 500 is the ideal range, though.
Since my valve isn't that big, I might as well replace the whole valve.
You'll have things disassembled getting to the solenoids to test them. Disconnect the wires, put in the new valve, screw everything back into place, reconnect the water, turn on the water, then see if the water comes out the dispenser.